mind if I lose an election, but I want to lose an election fair and square. What I don't want to do is have it stolen from the American people. That's what we're fighting for, and we have no choice to be doing that. We already have the proof, we already have the evidence, and it's very clear. Many people in the media, and even judges so far, have refused to accept it. They know it's true, they know it's there, they know who won the election, but they refuse to say, you're right. Our country needs somebody to say, you're right. Ultimately, I am prepared to accept any accurate election result. And I hope that Joe Biden is as well. But we already have the proof. We already have tens of thousands of ballots more than we need to overturn all of these states that we're talking about. This is an election for the highest office in the greatest country in the history of the world. Every reasonable American should be able to agree, based on what we have already documented, that we need a systematic analysis of the mail-in ballots to review the envelopes. It's about the signature. And if they're on the envelopes, we can only review the envelopes, and that will tell us everything. This is the absolute minimum we should expect. This is not just about my campaign, although it has a lot to do with who's going to be your next president. This is about restoring faith and confidence in American elections. This is about our democracy and the sacred rights that generations of Americans have fought, bled, and died to secure. Nothing is more urgent or more important. The only ballots that should count in this election are those cast by eligible voters who are citizens of our country, residents of the states in which they voted, and who cast their ballots in a lawful manner before the legal deadline. Moreover, we must never again have an election in which there is not a reliable and transparent system to verify the eligibility, identity, and residency of every single person who casts a ballot, a very, very cherished ballot.